All right, it's got some suspension.
Oh no.
You wanna get in first?
Yeah, sure.
To be honest. Oh no, yeah, we chill.
It's like a surfboard, man. No, I'm just kidding. I won't break Santa's sleigh.
All right, guys, what is up and welcome or welcome back. This is Bexy Driver. It's Christmas edition.
Hell
and
yeah.
And here with me, why don't you introduce yourself?
The one and only Lil Huddy. That's me.
To kind of kick it off, people have seen us collab. People have seen us like in groups, like we've obviously have gone on trips together. People have seen us together, but we haven't really done anything one-on-one.
Not at all. I mean, maybe like once or twice in like a video online, but I don't think we've gotten to know each other on like this personal of a level for like a YouTube video, which I'm excited for today.
Definitely. And especially online, like a lot of people love us together. Like you're like my most highly requested Bexy Driver guest.
Oh, no.
Whenever I ask, like, who do you guys want to see on Bexy Driver? And they're always like, Chase, get Chase. And they're like, Chella.
Yeah, let's go. Hey, shout out to all the people that want to see us together, man.
What have you been up to?
I actually just dropped an album like a few months ago, which has been exciting because I had been making music for a year just for that like one point. And now it's like, oh, okay, cool. Like, what is next? And so I've been trying to figure out what I want to do going forward, what I want to write about, like, who I want to make songs with, because I had been working with a team of like 5-6 people, and like I haven't met too many producers and writers,
right?
Because I had been working with the same people from the beginning. So now I'm just like exploring all of my options, and it's been a lot of fun creating new stuff. I had a nail line come out pretty recently.
Check it out.
The Glenmetic.
When did it start for you? When did it start? Like, I mean, I was gonna ask music, but honestly, I want to hear it all because I don't know the full story. I'm new to social media, you know that, and it's like, when did you start? Were you on like the Musical.ly days or like?
Oh yeah. I hold on. There's a
bring
helicopter.
Us back. Yeah, should we wait
did
on
you
that?
Pause to the chopper. Hey, I didn't know they had helicopters in the North Pole, though. Santa, it's me. Santa, hey.
But yeah, kind of just take us back. Like I'm genuinely curious on like where it all started for Lil Huddy.
I started when I was like an eighth grader. I had a passion for both like musicians and like online personalities, and I thought both of those were pretty cool at the time. I thought the music industry was kind of like a foreign world to me at the time because all I knew was social media, but music seemed like so just like land of the unknown for me, especially coming from like a small town in Northern California called Stockton. Not too many people were familiar with making music themselves, but once you get to LA, it's like, oh, people kind of explain to you how it all works. And I'd been wanting to be a musician since I started social media, but like, if I take you back to eighth grade 5 years ago, I was like the cringiest kid you'd ever seen. Oh my God, if you see any of my old videos, I apologize to you directly. But I've made it a long way, and you've seen some phases throughout the years come and go.
With music being such like a foreign thing to you, was that always something that you were like interested in though? Like did you always have a love for music?
So highly interested. I had a family that loved music. Obviously loving music and making music's two completely different things.
Very.
And when you actually get into the making process, it's such like a enlightening feeling. You just feel amazed every time you do anything on a computer, and like especially with the guitars, with the drums, when it all comes together, it's like therapy to me.
Right. No, I get that. For me, I'm at the point where I love music, but I'm very self-aware, and I know
my voice shy. I can't sing.
I wish I could. That's one of the things I really wish I could do is sing, because like, yeah, that would be fun. But when did you know that you had like the talent for it?
I didn't. I honestly trusted my gut. And I had gone into like one studio session before, but it was only to mess around with some of my friends. That was basically it. I had no help until I really looked and reached out for it. And when I started to meet people and like book studio sessions, that's when I really started to figure out. I was like, oh shoot, like I could really make this work for myself.
Right. So run me through that process of being a musician and putting out your first song. Like, what's that like? Because I bet it's a roller coaster.
21st Century Vampire was totally different than anything else I'd been writing about at the time.
Really?
I'd finished like 80% of my album. I was working on it really hard, but by the time that they wanted me to put out my first song, I thought 21st Century Vampire more represented like a brand of being yourself and being vulnerable and like completely being who you are, I guess, is like one of the things I wanna like push out to people, is like I'm not afraid to be who I am, I guess. And that was the message I was trying to transcend with that song.
Obviously people know us and people love us together, but at the same time we're very different people. But
so on the opposite.
But also very similar in a lot of ways. We've had so many talks of just like you and I off camera that we've just been like, we just kept it real with each other. And but online we both have very different personas.
Yeah.
And I think that's one thing that I've noticed. Like obviously before coming onto social media, I'm like, damn, this little Huddy kid has really been like that voice for like,
what?
No, it's dope because you've kind of pushed this narrative on, I don't know, kids basically wanting to express themselves in different ways. And like people, some people saw it as weird. Some people saw it as just like, hey, I'm just trying to be me. And like, I think a lot of people have definitely become more comfortable doing that with your help. Yeah. And I think that's really dope what you've been doing. Like you were saying, you started social media, you started all this in like eighth grade. That being said, what was school like for you?
School just made me really sad at a point. And
yeah.
After I moved to online school, it started to escalate to a point where like kids really make fun of me. And so I just like, I distanced myself from school and I would like hang out on the outskirts. Yeah, I always had earphones in. I always had my hoodie up and my hoodie tied. I like didn't want to talk to anybody towards later into school. But I was such a social kid at the time. So it just made me sad that I couldn't find anyone to connect with like in my hometown, except for a few of my like closest homies. But everyone in my classes, I just didn't get along with. And it was, that made me so sad as a young teenager, because like through middle school and like elementary school, like school was great.
Yeah.
School was always great because no one cared about anything. But once it came to high school, it just became like much more serious. So I just caught myself in like a weird emotional bubble, I guess, at the time.
So what age did you move to LA?
17.
Wow.
I graduated. I did like a ton of extra work, like just so I could finish the semester
ahead.
Early.
Yeah. Okay.
And that's what I did.
When you moved out to LA, did you have like a plan? Like, was that when like the hype house first started, or did you move out just kind of like with hopes and dreams, or did you have like a solidified, like you had boys out here
before that? Yeah.
Really?
I had boys out here, and I was signed to a management in LA.
Okay.
And when I first came out here, I kicked it with a kid named Peyton and a kid named like Jackson Felt, and those were like my closest friends. And then we expanded our group. We met Josh, we met Jaden, we met Griffin, we met a kid named Sam Hurley. It was a whole extensive
That's
friend
crazy.
Group. And we traveled for a little bit. We did like a tour for fun when we were kids. I was like young 17-year-olds, and we came back to LA and we were like, we thought we were so lit. We were just like, dude, we're untouchable. No one can stop us, man. We're gonna be famous. We're gonna be famous, because we had just tasted like what actually going out into the world and meeting your fans was like. And so we were just so hyped as like young kids. And honestly, that tour kind of motivated me. It motivated a whole bunch of people, Peyton and Jaden, to like both make music, because we just fell in love with the feeling of being on stage. I could tell me and the two of them both enjoyed it like the most out of anyone. And and like seeing where we're at now is
crazy. It's crazy.
2 years later, almost three now.
All right, well, I mean, this is a Christmas special.
Let's talk about Christmas.
Let's talk about Christmas. What do you think of Christmas? Are you a big Christmas guy?
I'm a humongous Christmas guy.
Is it your favorite holiday?
It's definitely, Halloween and Christmas are definitely my two favorite holidays.
Top of your head right now, if I say standout Christmas, what was your favorite gift of all time? Is there anything that comes to mind?
Definitely my lizard that I got when I was like 7 or 8 years old. I was obsessed with the movie Cars, so I named him Ka-Chow.
Ka-Chow.
Ka-Chow was Lightning McQueen's like catchphrase as a little kid, and it became a meme over the years. And I think it's hilarious because now I have a lizard. He's a blue tongue skink. He's got like brown and black scales.
You got him when you were 7?
I got him like 7, 8, 9, something like that. And but I got him for Christmas.
He's still
from my dad. And he's still alive. He's like 25 now. 25-year-old lizard.
What's the lifespan on those things?
Oh wow, like 30 years.
Favorite Christmas movie?
It might be a little cheeky, but Elf.
Really?
Elf's great. Elf's so good. And then also
Iconic.
The Grinch, too.
Okay. One of the videos I planned out for this Christmas Vlogmas filming process that I'm doing. I said Vlogmas, and like you immediately caught on as well. When I said Vlogmas on one of my streams, that I said I was doing Vlogmas, my fans were like, you're filming every day? And I was like,
that's what I said.
Slow down. I was like, is that what that means? I guess I didn't understand what that meant.
Vlogmas was like a thing that like they used to do a few years ago, where it was like They literally every single vlog day? Every single day.
That's absurd.
That was back when Jake Paul used to post actually like every day. So
that's crazy.
So everyone just kind of carried along, like, cause
tradition.
Tradition, man. That, like, everyone would just do Vlogmas front to back. Like, so many YouTubers back when they just do everyday vlogging.
Sorry to disappoint. We're doing two videos a week. And one of the videos that I have planned out is like a Christmas trivia kind of thing. And I'm going to go around to influencers slash random people on the street and ask them like Christmas trivia. So I figured I'd hit you with a few just to kind of like warm it up. Let's try to warm it up.
Give it a shot.
All right, one of them. How many reindeer does Santa have? If there were reindeer in front of the sleigh, how many are we working with?
Eight.
You're going through the song. Eight?
Yeah.
It's actually nine.
It's not, is that nine. With Rudolph included?
Rudolph
you know
included.
Dasher and Dancer and Dancing and Vixen, Domin and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen, and but they do
and then recall. The okay, most so famous reindeer of all.
Okay, yeah. Whatever.
You killed it though. You were going through all of them. Wow. Frosty the Snowman.
Uh-huh.
What's his nose made out of?
Okay, so Frosty the Snowman was the
oh, he knows them all. So,
two eyes made out of coal.
You just skipped over it.
Oh.
Right before the two eyes.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
Frosty the Snowman. It's not a carrot, is it?
No.
No.
You literally hummed it perfectly. I thought you were going to have it.
Frosty the Snowman. No. Okay, I got it.
It's a button.
Button?
And a button.
Button?
Nose. Yeah. Weird. I need to look up a picture of Frosty the Snowman because I don't ever recall him having a button as a nose. What's the main character's name in Elf? Like, what's the elf's name in Elf?
Buddy.
Buddy. All right, last Christmas question, then we'll wrap it up. Okay. How do you say Merry Christmas in Spanish?
Feliz Navidad.
Can't stump this guy. This guy's on top of it.
You can't hoodie, stump man. Me.
King of Christmas. But that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. This is a great way to kick off Vlogmas. Vlogmas, you know, my version of Vlogmas. We're going to be posting every Wednesday and Sunday at 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And don't forget, tonight,
I'm going to be coming out with my Moment House live concert at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So be there. The link will be in the description. Come check it out. I killed it.
And, hell yeah.
Yeah, no, you killed it. Good job today, man.
The link will be in the description if you guys want to go check out Lil Huddy and his Moment House performance. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Like it. Comment your favorite Christmas song. And subscribe so you get those post notifications. And we'll see you guys next time on Wednesday.
Till next time.
Let's
go.